Hey guys, welcome back to your absolute and step functions review. This is the one with all the pictures where your constraint becomes very important, okay? And that's how you create all these pictures without realizing it. So let's take a look at the very first one. Number 16 is the one I want to do first. This is an equation of a circle, and if you're not familiar with an equation of a circle, that's okay, but then everything else I do expect you to know, all right? Now, if you look at this point right here, this is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. You see that 5? So, that equation, it is at negative 5 and 0. Here's your x. Here's the equation of a circle. So, x minus negative 5 comes out to be a positive 5. And y minus 0 with your radius of 1. And that's how you're going to end up with your equation. So you got x plus 5 square plus y square. Oops, sorry. There you go. And there you have your circle equation. This is the only circle one, okay? All right, now let's go ahead and start. Let's pick a few things that we know and we'll start filling them in. For example, let's do all the horizontal lines first. Number 10. You see how that's horizontal? It's cutting the y-axis at negative 6. So y equals negative 6, okay? And the notation for that is it goes from negative 10 to negative 5. There you go. You can write it like that, or you can just have a comma, either way. Here's another one I see that's a line. That one is at y equals negative 6 also, and that's number 11. And that one goes from 8 to 10, okay? Always go left to right, and that will make it easy for you. There you go. Alrighty. Do you guys see another horizontal? Yes, I see another horizontal at number 5. So on number 5, y is equal to negative 9, going from negative 5 to 4. Okay. Do you guys see another horizontal? Right here, number 17. So that one is crossing the y-axis at negative 3, going from negative 5 to 4. Because they are parallel. Positive 4. My apologies. Positive 4. Okay. Let me just erase that positive so it didn't look so bad. There we go. Positive 4. Do you guys see another horizontal? Because I do. Right here. And that one is crossing the y-axis at negative 1. And that number is 9. And that one goes from negative 1 to 8. So really, if you read left to right, it will make it so much easier for you to come up with your restrictions, okay? Do you guys see another one that is horizontal? Right here, okay? That one's crossing the y-axis at 3, and there's number 1. And that one's going from negative 3 to 6. Go left to right, guys. That'll make it easier on you. Okay, you guys see any other horizontal? Well, I see some right here, but these are step functions, okay? So I cannot use that one. All right, next. If I were you, I would do the vertical line next. So here's number 6 right here, okay? On number 6, I'm crossing the x-axis at negative 5. Oh, let's change pin. And that one is going from negative 3 to negative 9. But let's go low to high. So it goes from negative 9 to negative 3. And this time it is our y value, not our x. Okay? Number 19 is another one. Let's look at number 19. Number 19, you're crossing the x-axis at 4. And you're going from negative 9 to negative 3. Y value, not x, okay? There's your Y value. Do you guys see another horizontal? Yep, I sure do. Here's another one right here. There's number 3. I'm crossing the x-axis at 8. And this one goes from negative 6 to negative 1. All right, that is about all the horizontal and the verticals I see. You guys see anything else? Okay, so here's your next step. You could either start with the absolute value or function, and then you can do your linear, your choice. I'm going to start with the absolute. I'm going to pick a different color. Absolute, number 14, okay? This point right here is negative 8 and 3, and your slope is down 2 over 1. Alrighty, so number 14, y equal negative 2, x plus 8, plus 3, okay? And that one is going from negative 10 to negative 6. Alrighty, do you guys see another absolute? I sure do. Here's another absolute. From here, let's do a different color. Well, let's do the same color. From here to here, and that one is positive. And this one has a vertex of negative 8, negative 1. Okay, and that number is 15. So let's take a look at 15. Y equal, your slope is 1 up over 2, so 1 over 2, x plus your h minus your k, and it's going to go from negative 10 to negative 6. Just like that. All right, do you guys see any other absolute? Next one. What do I see? I see step functions. So we're going to have to write this a little differently. Okay, so here's your step functions. Guys, ready? Here's your first one. 1, 2, 3. I think it just has that 3. This one's going negative. This is number 12. Okay? Pick a point, any point. I'm going to pick this one right here. Your choice. I'm going to pick this one. That one is negative 3 and negative 6. Just so you guys know, negative 3 and negative 6. So let's look at number 12. So y equal, I'm going down 1 over 1, so negative, rounding down, step functions, doesn't matter if you round up or down in this case, x plus 3 minus 6. And I'm going from negative 4 to negative 1. Okay. 13, same thing. Except, your points are different. So I'm going to pick this point right here, and that point is 3, negative 5, okay? But this time I'm going up, and I'm going to round down, x minus 3, minus 5, going from 0 to 3. And it was included, so. Alrighty. Let's keep going. What other one color have I not done? 1, 2, 3. Okay. Next part. Here we go. Let's do a black also. All right. Now, on you get to number 2, number 4, and all that is going to be a little bit different. That's the only step functions I have, okay? Let's look at brown. Okay, let's look at this one right here. Now, number 18. Do you guys see 18? There's 18. Notice I went down 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. So 2 over 4. Okay. So your M is 2 over 4, which is 1 over 2. You got to find your B. So 1, 2, 1, 2, 3, 4. It's crossing at negative 5. And I just counted, is all I did. So now I have my equation, number 18. y equal positive slope 1 over 2 x minus 5. There's your linear coming back, okay? And that one goes from 4 to 8. Just like that. There's number 18, okay? Number 4. Let's look at number 4. Number 4, let's find our slope. So you're going to go 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. Nope, that's not it. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. And it's positive. Let's go find what our B is. All right, so we're going to go 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3, 4. So that's negative 12. There's your B. So now I have my number 4. So my equation looks like this. Y equal 3/4 x minus 12. And I'm going from 4 to 8. Okay, there you go. Number 7, since we're sticking with all the positive, let's do 7s first. There's my 7. So here, you notice it's the same as that one. So number 7, your slope is 1 over 2, and your B. So I'm going to go up 2, 1, 2, 1, 2, 3. All right, now, if you will look at number 7, that B is question mark. So how would you go about finding that B? Well, you got an equation here in number 18. That is the same as that one, okay? We just don't know where B is. So we're going to pick a point, and I'm going to pick this point right here, 1, negative 1. I'm sorry, negative 1, negative 1. Now I'm going to plug into this equation of y equals 1/2 x plus b. You guys see that? What is your y? Negative 1. 1/2 of x, negative 1, plus your b. Solve for b. So negative 1 equals negative 1/2 plus b. Add a half, so b comes out to be negative 0.5. Okay, and there you have number 7. Yeah, it should be negative. Okay. All right, so number 7, your equation looks like this. It's positive, 1/2 x minus 0.5. And I'm going to go from negative 5 to negative 1. Okay, and there's number 7. All right, let's go to number 8 and number 2. Now, number 8 and 2 goes in a totally different direction. Okay, it's a negative direction, so it's a negative slope. So there's number 18, 4, and 7. Let me go get number 8 and 2. All right. Number 8. Let's do number 8 first. There's number 8. Okay? On number 8, my slope is 1, 2, 3, 4 over negative 2, which is positive 2, which is negative 2. And that's your M. Okay? Let's take a look at our B. Here we go. 1, 2, 1. So it's stopping right here at negative 3. Because of that, I can have my equation. So number 8 looks like this. Y equals negative 2x minus 3. And I'm going from negative 3 to negative 1. Okay, there we go. Let's go ahead and find number 2, the very last one. Here's number 2. Now we're going to find the y-intercept for that as well. Your slope's the same, so I'm going to go up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1, up 2 over 1. Up 2 over 1. Now, I can keep going with that, but if I do that, it might take me a little while. So instead of doing that, sometimes it's good just to pick a point, like this point, 6 and 3. Okay? 6 and 3. So let's take a look. So I'm going to pick 6 and 3. I know my m is negative 2. I want to go find the b. So how am I going to go find the b? So I pick this point right here. Okay. So plug it in. Y equals mx plus b. What is your y? 3. What is your m? Negative 2. What is your x? 6. What is your b? Don't know. Now solve. 3 equals negative 12 plus b. B is equal to 3 plus 12 is 15. So there you have your equation for number 2. Y equal negative 2x plus 15. And that one's going to go from 6 to 8. There you go. And there you have all the work for that last page. Okay? And that's where it encompasses when we do our linear. Good luck on your test. Bye, guys.